Hello everyone, welcome back to a new session on dentistry and more. So today our topic is Dental Council of India. So every dentist who is practicing in India must be registered under Dental Council of India. So everyone will have a council registration number, otherwise we are not supposed to practice in our country. So Dental Council of India is established in the year 1948 by the Dentist Act. So let's see the details about Dental Council of India, its election process, its duties and other elements of DCI. So we the dental professional, we must know the ethics of our profession, rules, regulation and administrations. So all these regulations are framed by Dental Council of India. So always remember this logo. An elephant and two snakes on the either side. So this is a supreme governing body of dental profession in India. And after the Dentist Act, we have already seen the Dentist Act. So after 1948, which was passed by the parliament. So landmark was this Dentist Act in 1948. So act came into 29th March of that year. Then after that, Dental Council of India was constituted on 12th April 1949, almost an year after the law was passed in parliament. So before dentistry was there in our country, but there was not any regulations. They were all included in the part B of registry. So let's see the composition, how the members are being selected into the DCI. So it selected from various categories of dentist. So each category, so there will be separate election. Ultimately, all the members will be selected to Dental Council of India. So let's see various categories. First one is a registered dentist from each state. So there will be around 29 dentists will be selected to DCI, one from each state. And one member from Medical Council of India, that is the second category. The third category is four people will be selected from principals, deans, directors and vice principals of dental colleges. So from all the principals, deans, directors and vice principals of dental colleges in India have a category. From that category, four members will be selected, one from MCA and one registered dentist from each state. So there will be 29 members in this category, one in this and four in this category, and one member from each university which is recognized by dental qualification. That is, we have around one university or medical university in most of the states, so each university will send one member to Dental Council of India. So there will be election and one member will be selected from each university and one member selected nominated by the state government. So again 29 people will be there, here also 29 people will be there, and one director of general health services, and six members nominated by government of India. Out of six, four members are from part A and two members are from part B. So part B, I mentioned those dentists who were practicing before the Dentist Act came into existence, that is before 1949. So after 49, all are registered into part A section of registry. So this is the composition of Dental Council of India. One from each state, that is 29, one from MCA, four from principals, deans, directors and vice principals, and one from each university, one from state government nominee, that is again 29 will be there, and one director of general health services, and six members from government of India nominee. Out of six, four from part A and two from part B. So this is the executive committee of DCI. So where the core decision of the decision of dentistry in India will be taken. So they have one president, one vice president, and five members are selected among the DCI members, and one ex-official member is director of general health services. So these are the executive committee, that is a core part of Dental Council of India. So what are the functions Dental Council of India does in our country? That is, they are the responsibilities, having responsibilities according recognition of dental degrees awarded by various university, and also maintaining the uniform standard of dental education. So they are the body supposed to maintain the dental education quality and responsible for the awarding dental degree. And they used to inspect various dental institution regarding its facilities, staff pattern, infrastructure, students welfareness, so they can put forward deficiency to central council and get it corrected. So DCA can withdraw the seat offered or seat given to each college. They can block the seat. They can prevent college to admit any further seat. For such things can be such decisions can be taken by these DCA inspectors opinions about the dental colleges. So another one, before starting any dental college or PG department, they should usually fulfill certain requirements. So every department, based on the number of students and number of PGs, there are few requirements that particular department has to fulfill. Otherwise, the inspectors won't give permission to start the degree. So they will report the deficiency to executive committee or DCI, so that they can't take up students or PGs. So DCI inspectors assess the standard of examination when first batch of BDS and MDS students take till their final exam. So suppose a new college starts in 2020. So the first year starts in 2020. So DCA inspectors will come till 2024 until that first batch take up the part 2 examination. Similarly, if MDS course starts in 2020, the DCA inspectors will be inspecting their examination till the first batch passes out, that is 2023. So these are the basic functions, along with it prescribes the experience required for appropriate teaching staff and recognition award by university and countries, and their curriculum, syllabus, credit hours, and duration of the course. So DCI is the ultimate apex body where a dental college has to follow the regulation of. And candidate should complete the age of 17 years at the time of BDS and will complete by 31st December of that particular year of his admission. So that is just how a student or how a student should join BDS course. So these are the basic functions what they do: maintaining a proper curriculum, quality of dental education, infrastructure of the college, the experience of the teaching staff, and checking the first admission batch until they pass out. So dental curriculum is completely organized and planned by the expert committee of Dental Council of India, and they have some ethical rules for dentists as given in the Dentist Act, such as they should establish a well-merited reputation, observe punctuality, should be courteous, sympathetic, friendly, and helpful, should not be any discrimination based on religion, nationality, race, and politics. And duties towards the dentist, like every dentist should cherish a proper pride in colleagues and mutual arrangements and emergency to treat the patient of another dentist. And they should not malign the reputation of another dentist whose treatment was found to be faulty. So always dentists should keep respect to each other. So that's all about Dental Council of India. When it started, its composition and its duties is important, and some ethical guidelines for the dentist. So I'll come up with IDA in my next video. Thank you.